TipKit in SwiftUI is an incredibly helpful tool for teaching users about your app by providing contextual tips and guidance exactly when and where they need it. It enhances user onboarding and engagement by delivering personalized hints based on their actions, helping them discover features effortlessly. In this video, you'll get a step-by-step example of how to implement TipKit in your app, ensuring you can leverage its powerful capabilities to create a more intuitive and user-friendly experience for your audience. And if you like these types of tutorials, make sure to check out the link in the description where you can have a one-on-one mentoring with me. Now, today we are going to talk about TipKit and how to set it up. What I have done is just created this starter project. It has a system image name, the text, and a button. As you can see, I just moved the image name and the text value outside inside the state variable, and then the count of how many times we tapped on that button. And this is our preview of it. And basically, that's our starter project. What we want to do is add some tips. So for example, I want to add a tip to my image, to my text, and also to the my button. But I want to start off with the image. Let's just say that we are going to have a tip about this image that it can be changed. And this is what we are going to start off with today. There are two types of tip views. Those are inline and popover. So in order to make the TipKits work inline or a popover, first we have to configure them. And it's just as simple as calling tips.configure. I usually do this on the app file because, you know, it's just starting the app, but you can do it on any type of view to your choosing. So first of all, let's import TipKit. And then what we want to do is just create the initializer in it. And then it's a throwing function. So why we just go try question mark, or you could just go with a do catch, whatever you feel like it. TipKit dot configure. Oh, not TipKit, but tips. Sorry. Tips dot configure. There we go. And you could just choose the one with the, you know, no parameters, or you could just add some configuration details. Let's just do that. We are going to add an array under the configuration. So it will be an array. Let's just see it is. And I'm just going to have control I so we can have indentation correctly. And there are a few. So if you add dot right over here, you will see that you can have CloudKit containers. You can specify the CloudKit container, which tips are set up over there, which means that you will have access inside app groups for your tips. And then data stored location, basically where in user defaults it's going to be stored. And then display frequency, this is what we are going to choose right over here. And let's just say dot, and then you can choose daily, hourly, immediate, monthly, or weekly. I'm just going to choose a monthly over here, whatever you see fit. Because this is a tutorial, I'm just going to remove this, but you know, just for you to know. Also, what I'm going to add right over here before I configure the tips, and you are also going to do this when you are testing, but you must remove this before you release your app to the App Store. We are going to reset the data store whenever our app loads. So I'm going to go try tips dot reset data store, because you know these tips have kind of these properties, when they should be shown, what frequency it should be shown. With reset data store, it's just going to reset everything. Okay, make sure that you are going to remove this before you release your. With 14 years of experience in iOS development, I've seen it all, from the early days of UIKit to the transformative power of SwiftUI. As your mentor, I bring over a decade of hands-on experience to guide you through the nuances of SwiftUI, ensuring you learn not just the how, but the why behind each technique. My mentoring sessions are built on proven strategies and real-world insights that will help you avoid costly mistakes, write cleaner, more efficient code, and build apps like a seasoned pro. Join me to leverage my expertise and take your iOS development skills to the next level with confidence. So let's go back to our content. Let's just wait for the preview to load. And what I want to do is just have an inline tip on the top of my globe. So first of all, we need to create our tip. And you just create your tips as separate structs. I'm just going to add it right over here. You could just create a brand new file for them. Struct, and let's just name this image tip. And it will be of type tip. And these tips, the tip protocol has a few. As you can see, we do need to, well, of course, first of all, we need to import TipKit. Let's just do that. It's just imported TipKit right over here on top. And then it needs to conform to some protocols. And the least is to add a title. We are going to add a title and some more. So let's start off with the title. And let's just have a text right over here. And let's just have this is an image view. Okay, so let's just see how this looks like. So let's just add this tip over there, and then we are going to add some more. So let's just scroll all the way up to the image right over here. And what you want to do, if you are doing this inline, there is a view for that, and that is the tip view. And as you can see, we may add the tip, optionally an arrow and edges. What we are going to do is just add a simple tip, just like this. So we need to create our tip right over here. So let's just have a private let. Let's just call this image tip because we are going to have some more. And that is our image tip, just like that. And then we can just add it right over here, image tip. Okay, let's just wait for the content view to reload. And as you can see, we have this nice view right over here, which is consistent throughout the platform. It's really nice. And it says, this is an image view. Really nice. But what I want to do is just also add an arrow. So if you add in arrow edge, you may add to the bottom, leading, top, and trailing. Let's just add this to our bottom. So we're just going to be added just over there. Really nice. And we are going to add some actions in just a second. For now, let's add some more properties to our image tip. And the second one is the message. So var message, there we go. It's an optional text. As you can see, text was required. Now it's an optional text. And I'm just going to copy out for time brevity. You can change, well, not to a dog, that is for my, well, yeah, let's just change it. You can change it to a dog, really nice. Now, let's just also add an image, var image, just type it out and you will see. And then that will be an image of system named, and I'm just going to go with the dog. Let's just go and add a dog right over there. Okay, and we should see it just over here after it refreshes. Still refreshing the preview. There we go, we have our content view. Really, really nice. Also, we may add some actions, which is just another property, var actions. There we go. It's an array of actions. And let's just have that array just started right over there. And what I'm going to do is just add a change action and a close action. So changing this to a dog, so the image to a dog, or just simply closing it, which would be kind of identical to tapping on the X right over here. So you just need to create an action with an ID and a title. So we do need to have the ID right over here, ID. And let's just call this change. It's a string. And then the title will be change to dog. Okay. So you can see it automatically added this right over here. It has this nice divider and it is bold. Now let's add a comma because next we are going to add another action, not change back, but clear or close rather. Close and then close, just like that. And now we have our close button. Okay, we have set all of these up, but we also need to, adhere to these. And that's where, let's scroll all the way up, the tip view has a completion. And it is, if you are going to use it, it's optional. It has these actions. Actions, add. Now we need to go through all of these actions and check their IDs. What I like to do is just use a switch statement, switch actions dot ID. And then we want to say case change. We're going to do, let's just set the image name to dog. Yes, that's a good suggestion because the image name is set up. And then we have another case of, I believe it was close. Yes, change and close. And then for now, let's just print out closed. And then, of course, because, you know, this is a string, we need to set up the default value. Let's just break out. Okay. Now, let's see what happens. So we have this. And then if we tap on change to dog, it just changed it because, you know, we just set the image name to dog. And if we close it, it's just going to print out in the console log closed, just right over there. Let me just clear that out and tap again. So closed. Great. But it did not dismiss it. And that's because it's just going to automatically dismiss when we are tapping on the X right over here. If we are having an action, we need to do this manually. So what we're going to do is, let's just start off with a close because yeah, that's how we are actually closing it. We want to set the image tip dot invalidate and the reason. Why? Well, action performed, display count exceeded, display duration exceeded, and tip closed. In our case, it's a tip closed. And then also, let's just add the same thing. So image tip dot invalidate and reason, not tip updated, but action performed, because we did perform an action. Okay, so now if we tap on change to dog, it's just going to remove it. Now, as you can see right over here, if I maybe change some things, maybe hello world, it will add it up because it already knows that we have set this up to renew the tips. Okay, hello world, just like that. And if we tap on, there we go, close, it's just going to close it. Really, really nice. Okay, so that's one tip that we are going to add. Let's add another one for the text. And I'm just going to copy out because the text tip, let me just grab it from over here. It is basically, it has basically the same structure. So it has a title. This is a text view, a message. You can change it to greet TipKit. And then we have an image, textformat.alt, and the same actions. Okay, so now let's use this text tip as a popover. So let's scroll all the way up to our text right over here and start typing out popover tip. And let's just use the one with the arrow edge and the edges right now. And the tip will be, well, we do need to create it. So let's duplicate this and let's have this as text tip. Well, we can remove it, will infer it automatically, and then text tip. And then we can add text tip right over here, arrow edge dot up or top, sorry. And then for the actions in, we are going to add the same thing again, but you see now it has changed to greet tip close, but we are not actually executing anything. So let me just copy this out and paste it over here. Change where we are going to say that the text value should be hello TipKit. So text value hello TipKit, and then text tip invalidate with the action performed. And then also when we are closing, text tip invalidate with the reason of tip closed. Okay, so let's see if that works. Change to greet TipKit, hello TipKit. It's really nice. And change to dog, there we go. It's just going to change it to go. Now you will see, you see that it just moved up because the first one, the tip view was in line. It wasn't a popover. Of course, This is really simple, but as you saw, they just overlapped. And let me just do that again. Maybe just have a new adding it over here, and it should just refresh. Let's just see, how should we refresh this? Hello. There we go. Okay, so now we have both tips presented immediately on our view, which is not great. And this is what we are going to talk about in the second video, and even more. We are going to talk about events and also some parameters. So go ahead and check that out. The link will be down in the description too. And if you like this teaching style, go ahead and check the other link, which is rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a one-on-one Zoom call where I can help you with your iOS problems.